Of course, this is Windows XP, right? Right? Psych! This is Windows 10 with XP theme, programs, and functions. Go back to the installation, it identifies that it is Windows 10 with its setup, of course. But I want to install it not on a virtual machine, but on an actual machine, using my reliable SanDisk Crucible 32GB USB 2.0, using Rufus to make the ISO a Windows 2 Go disk. Boot it into the desktop, install some drivers, and here we go! As you can see, this does look like Windows XP by its icons, taskbar, and desktop. Spawning the start menu, this really is Windows XP start menu. Although the internet and email text isn't bold like what Windows XP does, but this can fool many people into thinking that this is Windows XP. Okay, the look is Windows XP, but what about the applications? Oh, you ask? We got Windows XP applications here. Oh boy, mentioned in a rush moment. Magnifier, on-screen keyboard, hyperterminal, remote desktop connection, sound recorder, volume control, Windows manipulator, calculator, command prompt, notepad, paint, synchronization, tour, full freaking Windows XP!
Welcome to Windows XP from Microsoft.
Word pattern character map. Yeah. Windows Explorer in here is really just looking very sus.
Sussy baka.
I mean, it does, pixel to pixel, looks like the XP variant. Windows XP icons are also used in here too. Windows XP games such as Solitaire is available in here. Quote unquote, Internet Explorer is in here too, and by that I mean it's Firefox 109 skin to look as close as possible to IE6. Oh, far out, everything in here looks so close to the original Windows XP. I've got so sussed by this multiple times. The hell with this goddamn AliExpress. MSN Explorer and Windows Messenger is in here too if you want to use it, but although, to be fair, MSN Explorer isn't really working due to ambiguous status of the service, and Windows Messenger is shutting out service, but hey, you can use Escargot to patch the service and still chat in it. Still sounds win to me. Windows Movie Maker, for those you 2008 people, is available in here. If you want to make any tutorial video, be sure to install unregistered Hypercam, install Notepad in the taskbar to make sure any notes is saved in there. Windows 10 Task Manager has been substituted by the XP version, well that's great. XP wallpapers are also bundled in here and can be changed by right-clicking the desktop and click Properties as if in Windows XP. Screensavers are also in here. I was worried that at the time, because I'm recording this on an actual machine, the screensaver won't gonna be get captured, but hey, as you can see, it is well intact. In this mod, you're not only getting Lunar Look, but you also get 6 other Windows XP style theme in here as you can witness. In this case, I wanna use Royal Noir. Oh, oops, Zuna theme, changed my mind. Windows XP sound scheme is already set up in here, so you can use it. Oh, you haven't seen the boot screen, aren't you? So, looking at my footage, although the Windows logo is still Windows 10, the login screen is using the classic login screen. Remember that this is Windows 10? Yeah, since this is based on Windows 10 LTSC 2019, you can still use Windows 10 features in here, such as AeroSnap, Virtual Desktop, Windows 10 Task Manager, Windows 10 Settings, Windows 10 Start Menu by holding Shift key while clicking the Start Menu or Windows key, Windows Search and Action Center, or also, don't forget about ISO and VHD mounting too. Travis, who mainly created this mod, is also including 2 extra packs for Windows Experience. The first part, which includes era-appropriate icons for several programs, Microsoft Plus, Tablet PC Pack, XP Media Center Edition, and Tablet PC Edition programs. Over 70 new wallpapers, including Windows XP Starter regular wallpapers. Well, in this case, I want as Jakarta as the desktop background. The second part includes several beta themes, quote-unquote Internet Explorer upgrade, and even more wallpapers. You can upgrade the look of Internet Explorer from IE6 to IE7 or IE8. This can't be reversed though, so choose it wisely. Wait, is this looks wrong? Am I thinking? Oh, bah. It upgraded into Firefox 111. Far out. Alright, move on to the next extra. More wallpapers. After I installed it, it includes many extra wallpapers such as Aurora, Experience Aurora, Longhorn Aurora, and Beta wallpapers, but I'll stick with Jakarta background to make my Indonesian viewers happy, you know. The last one is additional beta theme, which are watercolor, blacks, and slate. Alright, let's set wallpaper as a theme, but why is my laptop not responding? Oh, crap. Alright, after a restart, why does this theme look cursed? Zune window style, but with watercolor window matching in start menu? Oh my goodness. Now it looks right. And here is for slate, and here is for plex. Pretty cool, right? This is a pretty cool job done by Travis and the team over the Discord server. I really give this one a salute because this really makes me thinking that this is Windows XP. Even my girlfriend didn't even notice that this is Windows XP, right, Elita?
This looks like what I used to see, but this camouflage really got me.
Even though this mod has taken many things to transform from Windows 10 to Windows XP, there's still bugs and weirds that exist. Address book is redirected to context folder, command prompt is using the Loon theme instead of its Win32 custom classic theme, tasks list at the left side of Windows Explorer is only decorational since clicking it only redirects you to My Computer, appearances tab crashes when you are clicking it, Windows XP sound scheme isn't set by default for some reason, narrator isn't running with its copy file dialog, Pinball's window layout is completely white for some reason, and the taskbar looks a bit off on multiple monitors. But look, no worries, because this mod is still in development, as the Harmony update will likely release in this short time. If you wanna try or use this out, I'll put the link into the Discord server and the download link in the description. Thank you, Travis and the team, for making this mod. Thank you for my Patreon supporter for making this video possible, and I'll see you in the next video of Everything Windows. See you next time. Goodbye.